So have you ever felt that in reaching your next goal, reaching the next level of your financial life, that you knew exactly what you're supposed to do, but yet you didn't do it? Why? Well, I'll discuss in this episode of the 7-Figure Squad. Now, I want to warn you, this might sting a little bit, but let's get started. Starting in 3, 2, 1, let's go.
Never short stopping, now I'm winning like I'm Jeter. Steady through the rigor, yeah, I'm getting bigger. Just fighting in them trenches, now I'm making 7 figures like.
What's cracking, everybody? Money Smart Guy Matt Sapaula here, hailing to you from Dallas, Texas, and we are in the mix of Vlogmas. And what is Vlogmas? Every day, we're putting in an episode every day from the 1st of December all the way into Christmas, because we want to show you how to think like a millionaire, how to strategize like a millionaire. So therefore, in 2022, you become a first-generation cash flow millionaire. If you feel that we're providing value to you, please click like on this video, hit subscribe, because our journey to 150,000 subs, we are right there, because we want to award a church, charity, or a nonprofit $5,000 on behalf of you, the squad, members of the 7-Figure Squad, to help that charity, nonprofit organization help other people. Okay, so let's get into it. What is this thing I'm talking about that keeps you from getting to the next level of your financial life, next level in your relationships, next level in your career, next level in your business? What is it? Here it is. Laziness. Woo! Laziness. Are you lazy? Because you just might not be broke and get to the next level, bro. Sis, you're probably just lazy. Let's read here what scripture has to say. Yes, in the Bible, they got things about laziness in the Bible that might shock you. Let's take a look at some of these scriptures. In Proverbs 10, it says, "Lazy hands bring poverty, but hardworking hands lead to wealth. Whoever harvests during summer acts wisely, but the son who sleeps and sleeps in during harvest is disgraceful." In Proverbs 13, it says, "The appetite of the sluggard craves, but gets nothing, but the desire of the diligent will be abundantly satisfied." In Proverbs 12, it says, "Work hard and become a leader. Be lazy and become a slave." Proverbs 14, for all you talkers out there, it says here, "All brings a profit, but just mere talk leads only to poverty." Proverbs 20, "If you love sleep, you will end in poverty. Keep your eyes open and there will be plenty to eat." Proverbs 21, "Good planning and hard work leads to prosperity, but hasty shortcuts lead to poverty." Still in Proverbs 21, it says here, "Despite their desires, the lazy will come to ruin, for their hands refuse to work." In 1 Timothy chapter 5, it reads, "If anyone does not take care of his own relatives, especially his immediate family, he has denied the faith and is worse than an unbeliever." Now, this may even sting even more. Oftentimes, the lady's like, "Okay, guys, get to work, get to work." No, the Bible talks about women getting into work, getting their hands in the mix too as well. Let's take a look at what it says in Proverbs. It reads like this. Proverbs 31, "She seeks out wool and linen with care and works with willing hands. She considers the field and buy it. With the fruit of her hands, she plants a vineyard. She girds her loin with strength and strengthens her arm." It continues in Proverbs, "Her hands are busy spinning thread, her fingers twisting fiber." See, a woman is getting involved. So many things that you see today, you see, oh, what traditional man or traditional woman or non-traditional man or not. Well, listen, the way I look at things, I like to reference things according to the Bible, according to scripture. Why? Because it's not enough just to be a good person. It's just not enough to be a good person just today. It has to be grounded and anchored on things that doesn't cause me to stray from values and principles that have anchored and stood the test of human history. But let me break down to 3 different types of laziness. Oh yeah, there's levels to this game. Number one, it's physical. Physical is neglecting work and duties. You'd rather sit down than get up and get to work. So that's physical laziness. The second type of laziness is mental. Mental is common, even in kids in school. My wife and I, we just came back from a parent-teacher conference this morning. And it's obvious that a lot of kids naturally are mentally lazy. It's human nature to take the easy way out. It's human nature to want to take a shortcut. And here's what a lot of people don't like to hear. Overnight successes usually take about 10 years. So if you want to get to work today and you want to be a quote unquote overnight success, guess what? It's not going to happen for another 10, maybe in 15, maybe in 20 years. Listen, I've been an entrepreneur now going into my 23rd year as an entrepreneur. It took me 5 years before I started making 100,000 to 250. It took me 10 years before, you know, if you calculate all that stuff together, it took me 10 years to make my first million. But to become a cash flow millionaire in 1 year, it took me 17 years. By the way, I've been distracted many times in my life. Wrong relationships, been distracted by different opportunities, been distracted by the wrong investments instead of focusing on one thing. You know why? Because I discovered in myself, there's a bit of laziness inside me. Which leads me to the third type of laziness, which is spiritual. Being spiritual lazy means that you lack using your God-given talents. By the way, you have them. You know you have them. You've been lazy in extracting it and implementing it and honing it and perfecting it. But God has given you special talents, and even more so, he's given you special purpose in your life. You just got to go out there and dig and find it. And just consider this. In the Bible, even in Genesis, God even worked. As much as God was God, but God worked for 6 days straight. And then he took a day off. So back to my signs. Because here's the bottom line. We like to have a better life. Yet these different types of laziness attacks us in many different directions to not create that reality. So here are my 3 signs that you are lazy and what you should do about it. Number one, you watch TV and social media more than you read. The crazy part, I was reading this fact. So according to Statista.com, on average, people spend approximately just under 2 hours a day on social media. Let's check out some of these time frames here on MediaKicks.com. A lot of people spend 40 minutes on YouTube, 35 minutes on Facebook, 25 minutes on Snapchat, 15 minutes on Instagram, a minute on Twitter, and 95 minutes on Twitch. Which one of that is you? Which one of those is, okay, I got an Insta account, Facebook account, YouTube account. And by the way, thank you so much for watching this YouTube channel. If you are watching something, check this out. If you are watching something, it's not for just simply checking out entertainment. If you are watching something, it's because you're diligently watching something, so therefore you can take notes. Because when you're taking notes, you're also engaging reading. And when you're engaging reading, guess what happens to your brain? It starts growing. Synapses in your brain starts to invoke emotional intelligence. You start understanding where you fit in the world, where you start fitting in, where in your environment, and how you're supposed to fit in with the God-given purpose and dream he's given you. Reviews.org even published this. It says that people are watching Netflix for over 612 hours or 25 days on Netflix during this pandemic. So let me flip this real quick. So instead of watching too much TV, what should you be doing? Reading. Why reading? Reading allows you to increase your intelligence, boost your brain power, and helps you become more empathetic. Yes, empathetic. You're understanding other people's plight. You understand other people's situation. So therefore, you can be a better entrepreneur. You can be a better manager. You can be a better CEO, boss, because you're more empathetic. Why? Because you read. And by reading, you're understanding other people's worlds and their ability to discuss and share with you what they're experiencing. So therefore, hey, you know what? I can understand a person's situation. This author that's talking about this scenario, I fit in that scenario too as well. This is some of their behaviors through it and how they championed through it, how they got set back through it. Hey, I'm understanding other people's situations. So therefore, when I'm helping people in my staff, helping people in my community, helping people in my company, guess what? Helping people in my church, guess what? I am more empathetic to their situation and I'm less judgmental. So if that's you and you affirm this belief, put it in the comment section below. I am reading more to become a millionaire. I am reading more to become a millionaire. Number two, you do nothing on weekends. You do nothing constructive on weekends. You sleep in. You're bored. You roll around. You just simply watch TV. You just let the whole Saturday and Sunday just pass you by. And then you have this attitude on Sunday night. Oh God, I gotta work on Monday. You got this pit in your stomach because you have zero purpose and direction and drive in your life. Listen, here's what I know about my millionaire buddies. The people that I've met along the way to get to 100,000 a year, 500,000 a year, $1 million a year, when we go on vacation, you know what we can't wait to do on Sunday nights? You know what we can't wait to do on the last day of our quote unquote vacation? You know what we can't wait to do? Get back to work. We cannot wait to get back in the salad. Do you know why? Because we have something constructive to do on weekends. We have something constructive to do on vacation. And it causes us to say, I got more energy to apply it to my business, to apply it to my endeavors, to apply it to my goals. You know what millionaires do on weekends? Here's a few things. Number one, they still wake up early, just a little later than during the week. So they sleep in a little bit. I'm not saying they're not catching up on sleep on weekends, but they still wake up early on Saturdays and Sundays. They just don't sleep until 12 o'clock. Number two, they have anchor activities. What are those anchor activities? church, they pursue interests, unwind with personal passions, and they intentionally spend time with family and friends. And number three, they reflect, they meditate, and furthermore, they organize. Yes, they get things cleaned and organized. Why? Because a disorganized, dirty environment causes laziness to come in, because you're saying, hey, I can't find it anyway. I'm disorganized. Man, one of the things I learned from the military, things are in order, because when you are in a situation where push comes to shove, you got systems, checklist, you got your flyaway kit, you're ready to go. You are force in readiness. And that is a habit that millionaires invoke on a daily basis. Bottom line, I've used my evenings and weekends simply to catch up on my competition and lap them. So if you want to be a first generation cash flow millionaire in 2022, guess what? Have a different habit as it relates to your weekends. And shoot, watching this right now here during the middle of the week, you can start now this week. Don't wait for next year. Do it now this week. So if that's you, put in the comment section below. I am making constructive use of my weekends. I am making constructive use of my weekends. Number three, you give yourself excuses not to exercise. You give yourself excuses not to follow a proper diet, to take care of your body. Here's the bottom line. Your body is going to cause you to want to do a lot of things or not to do a lot of things. How you feel about your body and how your body makes you feel causes you to say, you know what? Let's get after it. Or, man, you know what? Not right now. Guess what happens when you don't exercise? A few things come to mind. Number one, it causes you to have a habit of procrastination, that you wait until the last minute to do something. That's a sign of laziness. You're not preparing for yourself. We have a saying here at our office: if you're on time, you're late. But if you're early, you're on time. Number two, you allow bad food and food intake to enter your body. You know, here's what I observe about my Muslim brothers and sisters. Here's what I observe about my Jewish brothers and sisters. You know what I notice about them? They eat halal food. It's blessed food. Only a certain type of meat that they eat and they consume is called halal in the Muslim faith. Jewish, kosher. So in other words, they're focused so much on what they put into the body, because if they don't put certain things in their body, it's against God. It's against their ability to take care of their temple, which is their body, and it causes them not to operate in the highest optimal rate according to their purpose in their lives. And number three, last but not least, exercise reminds you every day to push your limits, to not be content. You should always be moving forward. Listen, if you get to the top of your current level, hello, you're now at the bottom of the next level. And you get to the top of that level, hello, you're at the bottom of the next level, so on and so forth. Well, Matt, when does it ever stop? Well, it's not supposed to stop. One of the greatest things that has invoked in our country, United States of America, is this concept of retirement. What's the dream that people sell you about retirement? You're not working anymore. You're sitting on the couch. You got the remote control. Guys, that gets boring very quickly, especially after you spend your entire life on productivity. Now you can sit on your butt and watch TV, not get involved in how you can contribute back to the younger generation. See, that's laziness. And retirement, guess what? That mentality of retirement breeds laziness. Now, I didn't say not for you to save. I didn't say not for you to invest, because I want you to be financially independent. I didn't say retire. Like, you completely checked out and unplugged from the world. No, you're supposed to give back. You're supposed to be a contributor to society. You're supposed to help the younger generation, your friends, your family, come out for those of them that have the same guidance and blessings that you have. That being said, guys, I'll know your thoughts, your comments. Before I let you guys go, check out this video here, mastering one skill that can make you a millionaire in 2022, and also my millionaire morning routine that you should consider invoking your schedule for the year ahead. Guys, if you haven't done so already, please click like and follow our Facebook business page, Money Smart Guy. If you haven't done so already, if you're watching this on YouTube, make sure you click like, subscribe, and hit notifications to be alerted the next time we upload our next episode. From Dallas, Texas, I'm your Money Smart Guy, and until we meet again, continue to live smart, continue to love smart, and be money smart today. See you tomorrow.